हाय हाय
हाय
नंदन,
सर,
आर यू
होप आई
एबल
एम
टू हियर
ऑडिबल।
मी? या
यस सर, आई एम एबल टू
यस
हियर।
यस या सो आई थिंक वी आर डॉट ऑन टाइम नाउ. इट्स एग्जैक्टली 5 o'clock. आई थिंक वी कैन स्टार्ट. आई कैन सी सम पीपल हु हैव जॉइंड ऑल्सो. मेनी ऑफ आर फेलो सार्थियंस हैव जॉइंड.
थैंक्स ऑल, थैंक्स फॉर जॉइनिंग।
या एंड थैंक यू नंदन फॉर जॉइनिंग द सिब्स टॉक टुडे. So
थैंक्स।
can you first, we'll start by you introducing yourself and telling us a little bit.
Yeah, so myself, I'm Nandan, Nandan Vandre. I'm born and brought up in Pune. So I did all my schooling, college, engineering, everything Pune itself. I'm a Bishopite. Then I studied 12th science in Wadiyar. Then I did my engineering from Pune Vidyapeeth Engineering College. I'm a mechanical engineer. Currently, I'm working with Tata Consultancy Services as a consultant. And, yeah, I have along with my parents and my wife, Dr. Pallavi, and then 8-year-old son, Sahil. So
Oh,
this is my
that's nice.
family and my background.
Okay, that's lovely. And can you tell us about your sister, your special sister that you had?
So, Sneha, my elder sister. So, we used to call her Tai, as it is said in all the Maharashtrian families.
Yeah,
The elder
the
sister is
eldest
called.
daughter. Yeah.
Yeah. And all. So, she was born in 1975. She was 5 years elder to me. And
Okay.
she was born as a normal child and all. But by the first year, she was here on a half or something close to that. And then she had something like a meningitis. She
Oh.
was given incorrect treatment by a doctor, which affected her brain. The doctor accepted that we gave a incorrect treatment, but now nothing can happen. This is going to be a lifelong challenge for you, and she will
That is
remain as a retarded child. So from that day till she passed away, she was having the her mental age was similar to a 2 year kid, and so we had to take care of everything for her. I mean, timely feeding, timely taking her to check up. I mean, it was like how you nurture a 2 year child. It was like an entire
yeah.
she later on could understand at times if she was hungry. Else, in the initial years, it was like, timely feeding her, taking her to toilet at intervals, because she did not have toilet senses.
The sensation. Oh.
Yeah. I mean, she could understand, but communication and other stuff was challenge. So, it was a hard time for my
Yeah.
parents. Because my
मतलब शी वाज
mom,
लाइक अ शी वाज लाइक अ लिटिल बेबी ऑल हर
it
लाइफ.
was like she was like a little baby earlier
ओके
then, and
ओके
stuff. But later on, she had kind of how the epilepsy people have fits and seizures, in
ओ
which later on she had some kind of disability, considering her legs and her walking ability also.
ओके
Also, we had a small house with a garden at our terrace. And so once she fell down, and in that she had her hip bone dislocation. And so after that she
Oh.
couldn't even walk. So there were multiple challenges on account of
Okay, right.
safety wall. So
Right.
yeah, this is how it was. And we were the way we lived when she was there was always an joyful environment, because everything had to be done on a timely basis. If she used to
Right.
get the and stuff on time, she used to be very happy.
She was the center of everyone's attention.
Yes, she was the center of everything. And me till my sister was there, we even if we faced any issues, they used to get resolved like a miracle. So
Right. Or other issues seem trivial. Yeah, true.
Yeah, yeah. And probably the way we approached any issues and challenges, apparently they were very difficult in the initial stages. But maybe because of her, we could always get some kind of strength and we could easily, you know, cross such hurdles. Even later on, used to, you know, feel surprised. Like, how is it like?
How did we manage? But
so
hats off to you and your, no, I was saying hats off to you and your parents also. To I'm sure it must have been a very difficult.
My mom, because believe me, my mom has not even been to her parents in those 33 years. She was, you know, all confined to home and taking care of my sister. And if we had to go anywhere, yes, she was along with us. So it was, you know, it was never a case like we kept her at home and we went. No. And believe me, whenever I was a kid, I never thought like she was a special kid or something. By the time I really grew up, I also felt like she's a sister. And
she's just my sister.
Yeah. I never even realized it until maybe till someone, you know, started staring when we used to go out. Then I used to start feeling, why are there people staring and all. Then later on, mom started telling me, like, you know, her physical condition might apparently be, you know, all normal, but this is the way she is. You can see her struggling and all. And the best thing is, due to my sister and my mother, you know, in my early years, you know, I started to understand what empathy is and the value of it. So, you
that's
know, that
so
is something,
beautiful.
You know, yeah, that is something I believe, you know, it's a gift my sister gave to me.
Right.
And, you know, saying this, that, you know, I mean, a special child or a special sibling teaching empathy.
Yes.
It would be something, you know, raising eyebrows to the world, but take it from me. This is the best thing. And, you know, they are the, everyone is aware, they are the most noble souls. They are, you know, very humble.
Innocent. Yeah.
Very innocent. And her smile, you know, it changed everything. She had a very good,
you know,
smile.
I can actually feel that you are remembering it so vividly, and I think it's in front of you right now.
Yes, it is. It is like, you know, we changed our home just to ensure, like, you know, she gets the best of everything. I mean, we used to stay on the fourth floor way back in 1990s when there were no elevators. So, just for my sister, we left Pune city and we traveled all the way to where I'm staying as on today. This is a place called as Baner. It's on the highway.
Okay.
Probably then, way back in 1996, when we started constructing our bungalow and all, it was like staying in, you know, a forest or a very,
very far away.
I mean, from my home, we did not have anything in the proximity of 3 kilometers. Only two homes.
Oh.
One far, a farmer who had his farm besides and us. And yes, believe me, like for others, it was like we were even on the outskirts of village. But the kind of, you know, longevity she had being in nature and, you know, coming to a
Right.
You know, those were the, you know, the best time we could really spend with her. And to our surprise, even with a dislocated hip joint, earlier she could not walk. Just because we shifted to this place, she had started eventually walking, taking help of a walker. Within her last few years, she couldn't walk without a support. So, you know, that is something very good.
And, you know, amazing.
For this, probably my parents, my mother and my father, they need to be, you know, applauded for it. Anything that is good.
Definitely. Definitely. They also and you also. You also have to take credit for this.
It will be most of them because, let me be very frank, my grandparents, they were not, you know, they were not educated. So when my sister was born, and the way the medical challenge happened, it was very difficult for them to accept. So eventually, my parents had to leave the home, taking my sister. So leaving just right. with a kid and with mere few pennies in the pocket and going outside and starting from scratch. So that is a big thing. I cannot probably think of that even as of today. But the way they have struggled, and the way they have groomed her as well as me, I feel, this is something even that I would like to learn as in today. You know, I have an 8-year kid.
As a parent.
Yeah. Him at times is, it's like,
So your childhood must have also been quite different as compared to others of your age, your friends.
Yeah.
And
so, because of we had a lot of challenges, people not accepting us. I did not have much friends. People used to be, afraid of coming to us. People used to, they used to laugh. They used to pass comments and all. But yes, at the end of the thing, at the end of the day, we all feel that is all situational. And just because someone doesn't know something, he cannot be angry on them. Or we cannot be even, cursing someone or something. Yes, it's all situation. And, the best thing is from all these experiences, what I could learn is, how not to treat a person. So that is the best thing I feel, my sister taught. Yeah, directly, indirectly, or anyway.
Yeah.
I'm always.
That's so amazing. You are actually able to understand even those people who are maybe not so helpful or not so understanding towards you. So.
Yeah, it happens. I mean, I say it's all situational, things change and all. But,
And I think in those days, the awareness also must have been less as compared to today, maybe because of so many other sources. Right.
Yeah, it was very less.
Can you share with us some memorable moments, some maybe happy or touching moments that you may have had?
I'd like to share something. Earlier when I was in school, so I would say in the 1990s, 1992, 1993, my mother used to take a camp, like the summer camp that we have for kids. On the similar lines, we used to have a camp for all these special children. So, there is a Bal Kalyan Sanstha in Pune, which is very close to the Pune University. So, she used to conduct this 1.5 or 2 months of camp where, all these special children, they used to come early in the morning, 8 o'clock, and they used to stay back till 6, and they had some fun games, activities, and so. And there was a very... very good swimming pool, which was specially designed for all the physically challenged or children. So it was me who used to take all of them for, swimming. I learned swimming while I was...
So you also must have been a kid at that time, no?
Yeah, I was a kid, but, I used to enjoy taking everyone to the swimming pool, putting the safety guards, and then, taking them to the pool. Making them go from one end to the other end, and the joy that you could see on their face. It's one of the priceless moments, probably. You cannot even imagine. And I remember the better part is how you go to sleep on your mattress. That way, my sister used to float on the swimming pool for hours together. We didn't even understand how it felt. a mentally challenged kid, secondly a physically challenged kid, but still she's able to float as if she's sleeping on a mattress. And these are something, and me, all these kids used to wait, when they used to come, they will have some breakfast, some activities for an hour, and then everyone used to be eager, when we'll be going to the swimming pool. And later, we really had to pull them out. Come on, air, it is 1 hour.
I can totally imagine.
And yeah, there was also an incident where one special child, she was senior to my sister by 2 years. I remember her name was Aarti. So
Okay.
after having food, she felt like she wanted to go to swimming again. And all of a sudden, she went running and she
Oh
in the pool.
God.
She started drowning and all. But you know, such are, I will feel, I'll say,
Yeah.
good memories. So
Yeah.
this is something you know I can share. Else,
It's pure bliss.
I cannot share other moments like how normal siblings run on. But
Right,
yes,
right.
but this is you know it is
Yeah.
more than
Yeah.
the most precious thing I have with me.
Actually, even our memories are special, I would say. They are not ordinary. Yeah. So did she used to come to know that you are her brother?
Yes,
She, huh.
rather after a few years, she was able to. She had a tongue toy which we had to operate, and later on, she could utter certain words and you know, she could communicate certain things. At least she
Okay.
used to you know, call me and my parents and few of our very close relatives.
Okay.
She was very much you know, affiliated to. She used to love being with them. So
So she
actually,
understood,
she used to call us by our name. Like she used to call I, Nandan. This was how much we could groom her, and she had that memory and all. So yeah, that is what I can.
That's amazing. But then you must have, all of you must have had an equally hard time getting over the loss also, loss of her, getting over the grief.
Yeah, actually, that is one of the most toughest period of my life because she had stopped eating for a week or so. We never knew such thing would happen, but yes, I mean, it was all of a sudden, I can say, but yeah, managing that was very difficult, especially for my
I can
mom,
imagine.
because the same thing, like 33 years to care of her, 24 hours being with her, and all of a sudden
and
they all
then
on it. So
right.
I had to, you know, understand the situation and console myself because I wanted to take care of my parents, because I've known the way they went through all the hardships throughout their life. So, I think understanding the situation, accepting it is something very important. And yeah, taking care of the family, I mean my parents, that was the prime thing. So, you know, that only made me very strong. And even we have seen our sister crying very, very less, unless and until she had a pain or something. I don't remember my sister crying any time. She was contented. You know, contentedness is something I could, you know, always learn from my sister. Because she asked for that. We had just a cassette player and certain cassettes of A.R. Rahman movies from that time. She used to continuously
Listen to the music.
Yes, maybe every 3 or 4 months, we used to change the cassette player. We had 3 or 4 back home and numerous cassettes. She did not really understand the stuff, but the music was something she could enjoy, and she used to continuously listen to that. And you know, what we call in Marathi the Balagi, Marathi kid song. She used to enjoy that. So that was the way it is. My mom did not sleep for 3 months after my sister passed away. So, you know, knowing all this, the only thing I could understand is, you know, taking care of my mom. And life
No,
will
I think
not
you've
give
done a great
you
job.
Opportunity.
You have.
No, the thing is, life will not give you a second opportunity. So, if this is the situation where you have to support your parents and, you know, you have to be strong and eventually take care of them, then this is something I have to do. There cannot be anything else. And yeah, whatever we had to do, we did our best in supporting her.
No, I'm sure. You are awesome. You and your...
I don't think it's the right thing. Instead of sobbing, someday someone is going to go. So do the best whatever you can for the person till he lives. That is what I feel.
Yeah, that's a great thing you just said. This foundation that your family, I think your family founded it, right?
The thing is, I told you, like, my sister had some disabilities and she couldn't walk for certain time.
Yeah.
So, we used to stay in Pune city. So, besides my home was the KEM hospital, King Edward's Memorial Hospital.
Yeah.
Which had a department for giving, special physiotherapy and all. So, it was called as Teredesam there. So, my mom used to take my sister there for certain therapy.
Okay. So
there were certain parents who used to visit along with their children and all. So, they used to meet together. And, someday or some moment, they thought of, sharing their challenges, if they can help each other or at least console in such cases where, at times they get frustrated. They really cannot express. So at least they have a parent,
someone to share with,
and all such parents have similar challenges, right? So there were a set of maybe 8 or 10 parents who came together and they started an NGO by the name Umed Parivar. So this is a Pune-based NGO. It's an organization of parents of mentally retarded and cerebral palsy children.
Okay.
The main aim is to get all such parents together, create an awareness on what are the social needs, what are the medical needs, how we really need to take care of the kids, and one more very important point which each and every parent does think is, till the person is alive, probably they are there to take care of their son or daughter. But what would happen
afterwards?
To my child after I'm no more, or maybe both the parents are not there. So
this is one of the biggest challenges, because
at times, even the sibling would struggle with his job or stuff to take care of, the child. So considering this, they came up with this NGO, and they have a place or they have their own establishment now at a place called as Vadki. So this is on the Pune to Saswad Road. It's a 50-acre place which was donated by one of the parents, and they have created a rehabilitation place where, all the parents with their kids, they can stay together, where you could engage the children with few activities, song, food. They have some recreation hall, gym.
So the parents also stay there?
Yes, there is a provision where, the parents can also stay along with the child. And in case, there is a loss, then probably the child would stay at this place and he or she will be taken care of.
So we have it's a residential facility.
Yeah, it's a residential facility.
Okay.
And Umed believes in, the same thing. Like, they don't want Umed to grow a lot. Rather, the main aim is to create the awareness among all the parents. And if parents can come together in small groups and do a similar activity at their own places, towns, cities, wherever, and they can come up with such kind of thing, that is what they look forward for. So they also host bi-yearly or a yearly state level conference where they invite all these people to schools, the teachers. They have a conference with experts on medical law and other areas, including health, people, right? So
that's really nice.
They have been working together, and they started all together in 1977-78.
Oh, and that they, long back.
Yeah,
okay.
Yeah. And this they started or they named this concept as Umed in 1990. So from 1990, okay, they have been working as the trustees of Umed Parivar up till now.
Okay. And okay, so your parents are still working.
Yes. My father has been elected as the president for this year, 2021 to 22. So even today he is at Umed, and they are
still working for the
Yes.
That is so great. That is so great.
I have a small bungalow, and I have a couple of mango trees and all. So every year we have been planting at least maybe 20 or 30 mango plants, and we have tried to make it all green lush, so that we believe, you know, our siblings or our special people out there, they don't have to go out and buy for, you know, very costly fruits and everything. Whatever they deserve, whatever they need, all would be within the premises of Umed Parivar. So having thought of that, we have planted, maybe 40,
I hope
50
to visit people. Your...
Yes, it's not only you.
I hope to visit all of us. Yeah. Yes.
Come down.
Definitely.
You know, spend some time with them.
I think we'll do that once. Yeah.
And, you know, have food with them.
Yes.
Believe me, they are so particular that no kid will, you know, start eating food without prayers. So that is something I will not do it.
Yes.
So that is what I feel.
Yes, yeah. we will definitely plan it.
Yeah. I think Rekhaji has been to Umed certain years ago. I just have remembered she saying it. So she is aware of it. So yeah, I would request all of you to please come.
Yes. We'll do that.
You know, bestow your grace and blessings.
No, we would love to. I'm sure we'll have a great time over there. So... thank you so much. It was so great talking to you today. I'm very thankful that I got the chance to talk to you.
I'm sure
Sneha is part of the most I think precious memories that you have. You will always have her in your memories. And thank
my
you for sharing all this.
My home is named as Sneha, so you know.
Oh.
All the time. Rather, we'll see. We are living in the grace that she has blessed on us.
True.
And believe me, in the moment she was there, we had problems coming and getting resolved in
no time. Yeah.
And after she is no more, then we have started understanding, like, you know, hurdles are remaining hurdles. So we can understand what was the grace she brought with her and what was the grace she took along with her. Anyway,
right.
We will
right.
always miss her. And yes. I wish you to the Sarthi, you know, anyone who anytime feels, you know, that he's down, sad, sorrow, he wants to share something, just pick up the phone, call Nandan. You know, keep your heart out.
Wow.
It's not Nandan, it's only one of us. So pick up and, you know, let your heart out.
Because I think we all got this support.
I could never speak out my heart to anyone at that time. So, you know, I understand what is the need. Someone coming and saying, you know, that is...
it's okay. Yeah, it happens.
Yeah, it happens. At least someone needs to, you know, talk. Someone needs to open up. That happens. And believe me, Sarthi is the best thing to happen to all of us.
I totally agree with this. Totally agree with this.
I've seen the kind of interaction.
Yes. I'm so thankful to Sarthi.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. This was so great. Okay. We'll see you again.
Yeah, thank
Bye.
You. Thank
yeah,
you all.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Bye.